Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Early on Saturday morning, SpaceX launched another Falcon 9 with the launch of the Hotbird 13F mission.
One, engines full power, and ignition, lift off of Falcon 9, go Hotbird, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Second engine cutoff, and there on the left-hand side of your screen, you can see that the first stage has begun the landing burn.
Nominal parking orbit.
Heard good orbital insertion there for the second stage.
Stage one landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
And there you have it. That landing marks SpaceX's 147th recovery of an orbital class rocket, including first stage landings for Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy.
Taking a look at the upcoming launches, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission soon. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Starlink 436 is scheduled for Thursday 20th at 3:45 PM UTC or 11:45 AM EDT. SpaceX has secured another launch with their Falcon 9 for a moon lander mission. Jeff Faust posted a tweet saying, Japanese lunar lander company iSpace confirms it will launch its first Hakuto R lander mission on a Falcon 9 no earlier than November 9th to 15th. SpaceX posted a tweet about Starlink for RVs. They said Starlink for RVs now has over 100,000 customers. Access high-speed, low-latency internet on an as-needed basis anywhere Starlink provides active coverage. Musk posted a tweet about Starlink. He said, also, Starlink is still losing money. It is insanely difficult for a low-Earth orbit communications constellation to avoid bankruptcy. That was the fate of every company that tried this before. When asked what the goal of Starlink was at a space conference, I said, not go bankrupt. In response to that, there were a couple of tweets posted. The first says, what's the threshold Starlink needs to hit to be profitable? I imagine Starship and V2 will be the key for this. Then there was another asking, Starship needs to fly first before Starlink constellations become profitable? Musk responded to this last tweet and said, Falcon can probably get Starlink past break-even, but Starship is needed to fund Mars. Musk also responded to the first tweet saying, Starship and next-gen Starlink satellites are key, but much risk lies ahead before those are working at scale. As well as having launched Crew 5 recently, during the week the Crew 4 mission crew returned home in their Dragon. The ISS posted this tweet saying, welcome home SpaceX Crew 4 astronauts after a 170-day ISS research mission that began on April 27th. Splashdown in the Atlantic Ocean occurred at 4:55 PM Eastern Time today. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of work on the structure behind the Mega Bay continuing. I wanted to share this really cool photo posted on Twitter by RGV Aerial Photography with a shot looking straight down the fully stacked Starship. This is such an awesome picture. They said, bet you've never seen the full stack from this angle. Crews were seen working on this ship aft skirt. The Starship quick disconnect was seen extended and retracted as they test it. The PES dispenser was installed into Ship 28's payload section. SpaceX posted this cool picture on Twitter of the fully stacked Starship. They said, Starship on the pad at Starbase. At some point during the week, Ship 24 was detached from Booster 7 slightly. Crews did some work and then it was lowered back down and mated again. As we wait full stack Starship testing, let's take a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website. Currently for this coming week, there is a possible closure scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 17th only. Grid fins for Booster 9 were seen being installed inside the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.